Welcome to Exchange Rates UK TV. It is the 28th of November, 2021. Taking a look at Litecoin here, starting off with a three-week chart. Three-week chart looks ugly. I mean, the last three candlestick closed on the 14th of November, then looking at the current week of the current three-week candlestick opened on the 15th of November, and it doesn't close until December 5th. So we've got, you know, roughly one more, little over a week left of this candle on the three-week chart. Price action-wise, what happened? So the last three-week candle, we had an amazing close. It was an overwhelmingly bullish close. You closed above the Tenkan Sen, the Kijun Sen, and Senko Span B. I mean, that was an amazing, amazing close. And then you fast forward to where it is now. I mean, it returned back inside the cloud. It collapsed below the Tenkan Sen, below the Kijun Sen, below Senko Span B. Just a very bearish kind of swing south. And the only saving grace here is that it's an inside bar. But the bad thing about that is if you're going to follow a trade using an inside bar, you've got to wait till it moves up quite a bit more. You know, basically more than 50% before you could enter long on it. So that doesn't really seem to work out very well. On the weekly chart, I mean, again, very, very dangerous level here. We have a breakdown level we identified in a past recording a while ago, back in, I think it was like late August, early September or so. But that level hasn't really changed much. You know, just like the three-week chart, you know, the weekly had a beautiful close 2 weeks ago above the cloud. It was above the Tenkan Sen, the Kijun Sen. I mean, it was above the cloud. Everything there was bullish except the lagging span could not close above the candlesticks. In fact, that's pretty much where it found resistance, was against the body of the candlestick back on the May 10th candle. And it was just kind of drifted lower there. But that means that the current zone here around that 180 level, that's where the lagging span will probably find some type of support if it does dip lower. But right now, it looks really ugly. Very bearish. The only thing supporting it is where the lagging span is at. Now that brings me over to our point and figure chart. So there is a short setup here that could be very, very bearish, lucrative on the short side, but painful for any long-term hodlers. I'm going to put that in here real quick. So the trade setup here would be an entry with the break of a double bottom. That'd really be the breakdown continuation move below the bear flag that is there. Haven't drawn the bear flag, really not necessary to do that right now. But the sell stop would be at entry would be at 190, four box stop with a stop loss at 230, and the profit target. Now here's the deal: we're using the vertical profit target method. The stop is like negative 10. I really don't think it's going to go down to zero or one. Really, I mean, I'd really doubt it would even get to 80. But that should at least give you a kind of an idea of the range. Maybe down to 100. You know, maybe. But that should give you an idea of the range that it could travel at least. You know, using a fib retracement, fib extension, the swing may only go down to, like 140. In fact, the 1618 on that swing there, actually I should probably have done it over here. My bad. Boom, boom, and boom. There we go. $160 might be the extreme, or $116 might be the extreme. That's the 100% extension is at 160. The 116 is where the 161.8 extension is at. So may not even get down to 80, may not even break the $100 level, but those are some levels to look at moving forward. Anyways, that does it for me. I hope all of you from the States, you hope your Thanksgiving weekend has been good to you, that you saw family, had a lot of turkey. And I hope we have a good week in front of us, because December is starting pretty soon. From all of us here at Exchange Rates UK TV, thank you for watching. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.